Nelson Piquet once said that driving the Circuit de Monaco was like riding a bicycle around your living room. And it's not hard to see what he means by that. There's no more prestigious a Grand Prix victory than Monaco, but also none so challenging. The prestigious Circuit de Monaco, then. It's not all that dissimilar today to the layout that made its debut almost a century ago. It's 2 miles and 19 corners through the streets of Monte Carlo, and although the average lap speed of around 93 miles per hour is the lowest of the season, the tiny margins for error make it the natural habitat of the safety car. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Ricciardo, Max Verstappen, and Perez, Norris, Vettel, Stroll, and the Professor, Gasly, Fernando Alonso, Esteban Ocon, and Tsunoda, Raikkonen, Mazepin, George Russell, and Mick Schumacher, Giovinazzi, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for those 5 red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going. Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. DRS as being enabled this lap, we can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. We're trailing our teammate by 4.1 seconds. They're on old softs. They're in third. The time last lap was a 1:11.5. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. New strategy is available on the MFD. In this lap, push now. You're incredible. decreasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. We expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. Caution, caution. Okay, clear. Right, some information on Ricciardo. They are out of the race. Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the ICE. Be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. Charles is out of the race. In front is less than a second. Let's try and get past in the DRS zone. car behind's tyres are in much better condition than yours. We'll keep an eye on the times. They're in 11th. The difference is 13.2 seconds. The time last lap was a 1 minute 11.0. Okay, we lost the position. Try to keep focus. They're in 11th. The gap is 13.4 seconds. The time last lap was a 1:14.1. Complete, go now. up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. Norris is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 2.3 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are 4 laps old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 15.0. Is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. Brilliant. Nice move.
Bottas is ahead of you.
The gap to the car ahead is 15.9 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 8 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:12.7.
We're slower by 9-tenths a lap.
In front is 17.2 seconds. You've lost some time to the car behind. that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. Okay, copy that. Got that, confirmed.
so Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, tyre management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Now, let's discuss, Ant, who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to the professor. Look at where they finished compared to where they started. It's not easy to cut through the field like that in Formula One, so it was a great effort.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, Alpine move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.